Our next speaker, in a way, is also something that I've been noticing a lot in the world we're in, which is it's increasingly hard to sort of pin a person down because so many people are doing so many different things. And this is certainly true of Samantha Strong, who is a real estate broker and a general contractor for Metamorphosis. Samantha came here from Chicago to attend McAllister College and I guess decided to stay. But she has been in advertising. She's worked in interior design. And then she acquired a real estate license in 2005 and decided that she had finally found her calling. She founded Metamorphosis Group, which is a residential remodeling company, and has launched Metamorphosis Realty, which specializes in urban and sustainable lifestyle. She was awarded the Contractor of the Year in 2011, and you may have heard her as a frequent guest on NPR's Daily Circuit with Carrie Miller. So please welcome Samantha Strong. Samantha.
Okay, one thing you'll learn about me right away is I'm very informal. I started my own business for a reason, so I could wear jeans to work every day. No, really, I got into this. It's a long story, and I only have 6:45, so I'm not going to go into it. But I'll tell you what inspired me to do it is when I was 20, I bought my first house when I was 24, and it was not in such a great neighborhood, but it was a great neighborhood for me. It was a great little house. And I had a contractor come out. I had a sustainable building contractor come out because I wanted to build green stuff for my house, right? I wanted to do improvements that were, you know, environmentally focused. I have a geology major from McAllister that's ingrained. So I had him come out. He talked to me. He looked at my project, and I had a little peanut 550-square-foot house. I just want to do a little shed dormer off the back, maybe have a couple bedrooms and a bathroom. He told me it would be $100,000. I looked at him and I said, that's more than my house cost. And he did not care. I mean, there was no, you know, like, hey, can we look at alternatives? Can we do something a little smaller? Can we try this? Can we try that? And there was no willingness on his part to collaborate or to try to find alternative solutions. And that really got something in me going. It really, really did. It was just, it irked me to no end that somebody was not looking out for my best interests. If I had done that project, first of all, I couldn't afford it. But secondly, I would have had the most expensive house in that neighborhood. And it just, it wouldn't have made sense. So at that point, I don't know, it really got things going. I was 26, and I wasn't able to realize it for another 4 years, but when I turned 30, I started this company, and it always had a vision of being a collaborative, kind of a checks and balances system of, hey, if I have the real estate background and I have the construction background, I can now look out for other people and help them. You know, you want to do a $100,000 kitchen remodel? That's great. Are you going to live in your house forever? And is your house X value? Does that make sense? As opposed to people using their houses for piggy banks, and we know where that's gone, everybody. So, yeah, so we're a little unique in the marketplace in that we do that. But what I'm here to talk to you today is actually not about my business. It's to talk about what you potentially could be doing. I just wanted to make sure that after leaving school and whatever you do out in the world, that if you have that entrepreneurial vibe, which I always did, I never trusted any, or never, I shouldn't say trusted, I never really respected and admired any of my bosses. You might find that out in the real world. And if you do, you might need to work for yourself. And if you're thinking about doing that, I'm going to give you 10 tips right now. I'm going to talk real fast because I don't have a lot of time, but I'm going to give you 10 tips to help you get things going in that regard. So this is a boot camp of sorts. Find your passion, okay? You need, as Don talked about just briefly, find out what it is, and Seth talked about it too. Find the thing that gets you going, okay, and do that. Because, I mean, heck, I work 6-7 days a week. I don't care. I love what I do. I'm solving people's problems all the time. It's just fun. Identify the problem in that industry. In mine, it was that there is no checks and balances. I needed to get out there and start helping people make good decisions about where they put their money in their construction projects in their homes. Devise a solution. I have to look at my cards or else I'll drift. Devise your solution. When you're thinking about this, spend some time tweaking it. I mean, this is your solution. This is going to be kind of the base of your business. You want to make a good decision here. So I knew I wanted to do something that was both real estate and construction, which are both my passions. But I didn't know like where to start. You know, do I need, what kind of licenses do I need? What kind of insurances, legal structure, naming? Oh my gosh. And a little thing about that. In retrospect, I might have picked a little bit of an easier name. I have had such brutal iterations, and later at the reception, I'll tell you some of those. Man. So think about your audience. Who are you talking to? You need to do research here. Do not just be like, oh, I've got a name, and I'm on the website, and I did a thing. Nobody will care unless you're actually talking to someone. You have a message that says something important that strikes a chord with someone. So do your research, find the right way to talk to them, and then in our case, we had clients that, maybe this was by design, maybe it was default, I don't know, but we developed a company that speaks to people a lot like me, so our messaging is fairly easy. I write things that I like, and it seems to work. So the next one, design your brand. Do something that's memorable, do something unique. Look at the competition. Do not mimic, be different, and make sure it relates to what you do. I'm sure we've all seen that logo that you're like, well, you know, like it doesn't relate to anything, and you're like, oh, they do, you know, healthcare branding, and you don't know. So right here, the lower right there, that's a different version of our brand. It's a one color print version that Adam Turman designed for a poster that we did a long time ago for a fundraiser. And it was just, you know, now we have it on file. We have it for, you know, we can use it for other events. Craft your message. It may take you some time to find the right tone here, okay? Try something. You know, you come up with your tagline or your messaging, and if it's not hitting home, if it's not striking that chord, try again. Do not get stuck in this thing that's like, this is the way it is, this is the way it has to be. No, your brand should always be changing, evolving, and hopefully, you know, striking a chord with somebody. It's taken us a few years to finally find something that really says what we're about, and it was actually something that I just threw out when I was talking to my staff about, like, this is what we should be about. Well, duh. It's real people, real homes, real value. Number 7. This is my favorite one. Spoil your clients. Whatever clients you get, it might be one, you know, that first client, spoil them rotten. Okay? It's all about them. It's not necessarily about you. Okay? I can't emphasize this one enough. Communicate well, as Don said. Manage their expectations. Do not overpromise and underdeliver. If you do that, you can't come back from it. You've lost their trust, and the rest is, it's gonna be an uphill battle to finish that project. Your client is coming to you for guidance, but in our case, it's still their home, so they have the last say. Value your team. Your team is, I can't see how much time do I have left? Oh, 30 seconds, okay. Value your team, that's your staff, your vendors, your subs. Once you find a good team that relates to your values, you hold on to them for dear life, you stand up for them, you respect them, and yeah, it's priceless. Maintain your integrity. Snafus happen. When they do, have a gut check. Fix it, do the right thing. Do not try to dodge it, do not hide behind it's gonna cost me money. Just do the right thing. If you don't, your reputation is on the line. Step 10, repeat steps 7 through 9, all the time. That is your career. Spoil your clients and value your team and maintain your integrity. We were at the Southside Housing Fair last Saturday and we had so many people show up. I mean, actually 10, oh, really? I get the hook? Okay, I get the hook. Well, thank you guys, have a good night.